Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. God be with you. Let us pray. Grant, O merciful God, that your church, being gathered together in unity by your Holy Spirit, may show forth your power among all peoples, to the glory of your name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of Joshua. Joshua gathered all the tribes of Israel to Shechem and summoned the elders, the heads, judges, and the officers of Israel. And they presented themselves before God. And Joshua said to all the people, "Thus says the Lord, the God of Israel. Now therefore, revere the Lord, and serve him in sincerity and in faithfulness. Put away the gods that your ancestors served beyond the river and in Egypt, and serve the Lord. Now if you are unwilling to serve the Lord, choose this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served in the region beyond the river, or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. Then the people answered, Far be it from us that we should forsake the Lord to serve other gods. For it is the Lord our God who brought us and our ancestors up from the land of Egypt, out of the house of slavery, and who did those great signs in our sight. He protected us along all the way that we went, and among all the peoples through whom we passed. And the Lord drove out before us all the peoples, the Amorites who lived in the land. Therefore, we also will serve the Lord, for he is our God. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
If you obey the Lord, he will watch over you and answer your prayers.
But God despises evil people, and he will wipe them all from the earth till they are forgotten.
When his people pray for help, he listens and rescues them from their troubles. The Lord is there to rescue all who are discouraged and have given up hope.
The Lord's people may suffer a lot, but he will always bring them safely through.
Not one of their bones will ever be broken.
Wicked people are killed by their own evil deeds, and if you hate God's people, you will be punished.
The Lord saves the lives of his servants.
Run to him for protection, and you won't be punished.
In the name of God, Creator, Redeemer, and Sanctifier. Amen.
Amen.
Last week at our vestry retreat, some of us were talking about what does it mean to walk around, particularly in the U.S., and say that you're a Christian. Feels uncomfortable to some of us, right? Not because of Christ, not because of Jesus. But because of the politicization, talking well today, but also the misinterpretations and the willingness to be so firm that everything is factual in the Bible. Instead of being curious, what can I hear anew today? How does this ring differently? And we had shared Bible passages on that retreat. Verses that spoke to us or challenged us. And we talked about going back to the Bible. Sometimes you just want to open up the book and see where you land that day. The way your iPod shuffle used to work. And what we hear in our gospel lesson today is Jesus telling us following God, loving God, not easy. That conversation about being Christian in the world reminded me of my hospital chaplaincy when I was all of 22 years old, and I was the chaplain for the NICU, the newborn ICU. And I walked in, and there was a family who had new twins, healthy, but just being checked out, and the grandfather was in there, and I said, "Hi, I'm the chaplain," and he goes, "What's wrong with the babies?" Right? That place of fear, that place of we only show up in times of danger rather than celebration. Our opening prayer each week always catches me. This prayer that we might perfectly love God. Oh my goodness. The Martha Stewart of a prayer. That we might perfectly love God is that we beautifully, imperfectly love each other, love the world, and love God. And I have a friend here today. We've been talking about what is God like. What does God look like? Hey, Lexi, can you come help me out?
All right, Lexi.
Do you want to share with them maybe the first page of what is God like? Your first page that you've marked. I love that you're so prepared. Thank you.
God is like a star, forever heaven. Even when we feel far away, we always look up and see the moon. God is like the shepherd, there and there. In the chapters, he loves the sheep so much that he watches over all of them and makes each of the day better.
Candle, like the light of a candle. Can you hold it up high? There we go. Thank you. This is a great preparation for all you readers or people interested in reading. See that? So this book is called What is God Like? And it was a book that was written by Rachel Held Evans, a theologian and blogger and writer who died before she was able to get it published. So Matthew Paul Turner helped complete it, and the illustrations are by Ying Wei Tan. Thank you. Can you all give her a hand? Things are bad. They feel worse than they ever have been. And I said, I think they feel worse because we have media in our faces, all around us, in our conversations all the time. Because think about the Israelites in Egypt, needing to walk through really a sea that shouldn't part to seek freedom, into the wilderness, where they're begging for God, food, water. And I think when we set those things down, and I love that Ephesians reading of putting on the armor of God, I'm not really big into war imagery, but I think that the armor is righteousness. And it's not that we have it all within us. It's God help us. In our baptism, we promise we will with God's help. And Jesus says, you all eat the flesh of God, which is communion, and God abides. God shows up again and again, and is often there, maybe kind of out of our, you know, in our blind spot, but still there. Still there in the midst of community. So I invite us in our prayer time this week, and I know we all have different ways of praying, whether it's walking or reading or talking. I invite us to set our devices down a little more thoughtfully, to maybe turn off the TV if that's a thing in your house, and look to each other and say, what are we thankful for today? What is God like? Right now, God is like music and people and church. And God is like people in need of knowing that. Amen.
Thank you.
Prayers of the People, Form 4. Let us pray for the Church and for the world. Grant, Almighty God, that all who confess your name may be united in your truth, live together in your love, and reveal your glory in the world. Lord, in your mercy, guide the people of this land and of all the nations in the ways of justice and peace, that we may honor one another and serve the common good. Lord, in your mercy, give us all a reverence for the earth as your own creation, that we may use its resources rightly in the service of others and to honor and to your honor and glory. Lord, in your mercy. Bless all whose lives are closely linked with ours, and grant that we may serve Christ in them and love one another as he loves us. Lord, in your mercy. Comfort and heal all those who suffer in body, mind, and spirit. Give them courage and hope in their troubles, and bring them the joy of your salvation. Lord, in your mercy. We commend to your mercy all who have died, especially Charles Vaughan, that your will for them may be fulfilled, and we pray that we may share with all your saints in your eternal kingdom. Lord, in your mercy. Particularly at St. Paul's this week, we'd like to continue to pray for Craig Costa and the Murdoch family, especially Charlotte and Walt Marcus. And for anybody else you'd like to pray for. I'd also like to add prayers for the people in Afghanistan and the people in Haiti and the people in our very own neighborhoods that are in deep struggle and in deep conflict. Lord, in your mercy. And let us now together, in the words Jesus has taught us, gather all our prayers and say this one together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The peace of the Lord, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always. Amen.
Thank you.
let us go forth rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.